The Federal Reserve is expected to slash interest rates for the first time in more than 4 years this month. Today's data will help them determine how much to cut. The government reports employers added 142,000 jobs last month, a slight improvement over July. Meanwhile, job creation slowed in the last quarter as over the past year, the government reported it overcounted new jobs by more than 800,000, including in July when they overestimated by more than 20%. While during that time, the unemployment rate ticked up nearly a point from a half-century low. It's slightly down from last month, but stoking fears the Federal Reserve may have overshot the soft landing they were hoping for, keeping interest rates too high for too long, successfully cooling inflation down, but at the expense of the job market.
The level of the labor market is not a problem. Like, it's still a strong labor market. The unemployment rate is still quite low. But the direction of the change is a little bit worrying. We kind of don't want it to deteriorate much from here, and it looks like maybe it is deteriorating.
The Fed will also take into account new inflation data out next week before making a decision on cutting back on interest rates. Keep in mind, if they cut too much, that could cause a spike in inflation, too little, and it could jeopardize the job market. In Washington, I'm Amy Liu.